This entire script was created using an AI YouTube script generator. And no, it wasn't ChatGPT. In this video, I'll walk you through exactly how I used it to reverse engineer a viral video from scratch in under 10 minutes. Now, imagine this. Over the past 6 months, I've been using this AI tool on weekends, and it helped me hit my first 1,000 subscribers without ever showing my face on camera. Honestly, it's so simple, even my grandma could do it. If you're a content creator spending hours battling writer's block or feeling stuck in a cycle of content burnout, if you're wasting valuable time jumping between different tools just to piece together one video, or if you're serious about growing your YouTube channel but hiring a professional scriptwriter at $200 per video just isn't in the budget, then this AI content creation tutorial is exactly what you need. Enough! You've probably seen travel videos like this before.
The USA occupies an area that's only just marginally smaller than Europe.
Great script, solid voiceover, catchy music, and beautiful visuals. Result? Over 24 million views. And get this, the channel only has 54 videos and already pulled in over 250,000 subscribers. Here's another one, same exact format. And another, same strategy, same outcome. Millions of views, millions of subscribers. These creators are literally making money in their sleep. I'm about to paste the link to one of these channels into my AI content creation tool, and you're about to find out exactly why. Now, this is Poppy AI. Wait, before you dive into creating viral scripts, it all starts with a blank dashboard. But don't worry, you can skip that part by grabbing my free Poppy AI template in the description, exclusive for Poppy users. Alright, now we're talking. This right here is my full AI content creation ecosystem. In this section, I analyze viral content to squeeze out every valuable insight, like top performing keywords, title styles, target audience profiles, and more. This is where I build a knowledge base to train Poppy AI to generate the exact kind of content I want to create, like the YouTube video you're watching right now. And finally, this is where the magic happens. I use Poppy to generate my scripts word for word with just a few clicks. Now, let me walk you through the behind-the-scenes process. First, we start with a full channel review. So I pasted the link to that large travel channel I mentioned earlier. And right here, you'll see this little node that lets you connect directly to the chat. By the way, I've already left the exact prompts I used inside the workspace, so you can copy and paste them to analyze your favorite YouTube channels in seconds. Personally, I'm using Claude Sonnet 4 for this part of the workflow, but if you click over here, you'll find several AI tools to choose from. At the time I'm recording this, there are 8 different models integrated into Poppy AI, and the team behind it keeps making solid updates. Quick side note, I have 2,000 monthly credits in my Poppy account, and before starting this tutorial, I had already used 7 of them on another query. So by the end of this section, we'll check how many credits it took to generate a 700-word script. Alright, so in the first prompt, I asked Poppy to analyze the entire channel and pull out key insights. That's why we scrolled all the way to the bottom, to make sure Poppy had full access to all the videos and metadata. Now, quick disclaimer here. Like any AI content creation tool, it's always good to double-check the results. These tools aren't perfect, and sometimes they miss the mark. But that's not the case this time. If you hit the F key, or just click here, you can view the chat in full screen. You'll see that the channel has 1.67 million subscribers, 129 videos, and their titles are structured with numbered lists to set clear expectations. Plus, their thumbnails are hyper-targeted to specific countries. Check this out. It also picked up that the channel frequently uses superlatives like best, most beautiful, greatest, and most mysterious. And honestly, that tracks. Those words are scroll stoppers. I mean, who wouldn't be curious about the 25 best places to visit in the United States? I also love how this channel targets US viewers by creating content for individual states. Let's keep digging. Oh, here's something else. Poppy flagged their videos as evergreen content, which means they're still pulling consistent views even after 2 years. One thing I originally assumed was that all their videos were over an hour long. But nope, Poppy noticed they also have shorter videos, like 13-minute ones, which is way more manageable when you're just starting your own faceless YouTube channel from scratch. All right, time to move on to the next prompt. This time, we're asking Poppy AI to pull 10 sample titles from the channel's top performing videos. The goal is to copy those titles and later feed them into our knowledge base, which, as you'll see in just a minute, becomes an incredibly powerful asset. So I'm pasting that list of titles right into this text box here. And don't worry if you need to rewatch certain parts of this video. What matters most is that the process is crystal clear for you. Now let's move to the next step of the workflow. This time, we're zooming in, not on the entire channel, but on 4 specific videos. The idea is simple. Find the most viewed videos on the channel, copy their links, and paste them directly into our Poppy dashboard. Right here, you'll see a space that explains the goal of this step, and right below it, I've added the prompts I used so you can follow along. We'll start with the first prompt, which tells Poppy AI to dig deeper into each video. We want it to extract and analyze the script, break down the storytelling style, and even go beyond the text to examine the visuals and the video description. So, I've gone ahead and grabbed the 4 most popular videos and dropped the links into Poppy. What's next? We connect each dot to the chat. Pretty simple, right? Once you get the hang of it, it's actually fun. And so far, I've only spent 10 credits total to analyze a ton of valuable data. Remember, I started with 7 already used. This is the kind of task that would take hours manually, but here we are, just 2 minutes in, and we've already got what we need. Sure, you could build your own custom GPT or use tools to extract transcripts manually, and that's totally fine. But if you're looking for the best AI for content creation, this just feels simple and fast. Here's the thing, prompting is everything. So feel free to use the prompts I've shared in the template or experiment with your own. Once you figure out how to use AI for content creation the smart way, it becomes second nature. Now that Poppy has analyzed the scripts, it's telling us the narration style is mainly educational. So I'm asking it to go one step further, to reread all 4 video scripts and identify any patterns that help these videos go viral. I also want to uncover who this content resonates with the most, and what keywords are helping these videos rank on YouTube. While Poppy's doing its thing, I'm grabbing a cup of coffee.
2,000 years later.
So here's what we found. These videos follow a clear pattern. They use countdowns to build suspense and keep viewers hooked until they reach number 1. This anticipation strategy is powerful. It keeps people watching all the way through, which boosts watch time and signals the algorithm that the video is worth pushing. Poppy also uncovered something else. The content sparks debate. These videos rank places, destinations, or experiences, which naturally encourages viewers to comment, agree, or argue, driving engagement up. And on top of that, they're using phrases like must see and once in a lifetime to trigger a little fear of missing out, which makes people think, I've got to watch this before I miss something important. Now, I get it. You might be thinking, this is a lot to remember, but don't worry, keep watching. Because in just a moment, I'm going to show you how to train Poppy AI so it can do all this heavy lifting for you. But here's something really important, the target audience analysis. According to Poppy, these videos are speaking to people between 25 and 55 years old. They're travel curious, likely college educated, and ready to spend money on meaningful experiences. That's gold. So if we want our content to reach the same kind of audience, we need to structure everything, from the script to the visuals, with that group in mind. Oh, and look at this. Poppy also pulled a full list of high-ranking keywords these creators are using to make their content searchable and SEO optimized. That's how their videos keep getting discovered, even years later. At that point, I had an idea. People usually plan their vacations months in advance, right? So why not create content now about the places they're dreaming of visiting at the end of the year? I dropped that into my next prompt, and Poppy asked permission to browse the web. According to the results, Japan is currently the number 1 most desired travel destination. Good to know, huh? And finally, Poppy went a step further. It scanned all the data I'd collected and recommended the ideal target audience and even the best voiceover tone to use for my Faceless YouTube channel. This kind of insight is pure gold, and the crazy part is how easy it was to get. You've probably seen videos from Calloway before. Personally, I found his channel super valuable. He shares some next-level storytelling techniques that I knew I wanted to apply to my own content. So, I grabbed his most-watched video. With this single video, I'm getting two things. First, proven techniques for captivating storytelling, and second, a blueprint I can implement inside my own Faceless YouTube channel. Want to see what comes out of it? Of course. But before we dive in, I need to feed all the insights I've collected into my knowledge base. At this point, my knowledge base looks like this. I've got organized text boxes for title style, thumbnail trends, audience targeting, and topic ideas, all pulled from my previous chats and prompts. And right here, I've dropped all the prompts I'll be using for the next step. But before we move on, let me show you a neat trick. Say you want to reorganize your workspace without dragging one block at a time. Just use the group feature. Hit G, place the group box behind your content, and everything inside clips together. Easy, clean, and fully organized. Now comes the fun part. We're going to train Poppy AI using all the data we just collected. Here's a quick pro tip. After you've trained Poppy with your knowledge base, go ahead and disconnect it. That way, it won't scan your entire setup every time you make a request. It's a great way to save credits over time, especially if you're working on multiple scripts. So, let's do a quick recap. First, Poppy AI analyzed that major channel. Then, we studied their most viewed videos, along with one key video packed with storytelling techniques we want to model. Next, I used all that data to fill in my knowledge base and train Poppy accordingly. Now, I'm using it to generate AI YouTube script title ideas and a complete outline for my video. But instead of a plain text outline, I'm getting fancy. I asked Poppy to generate a visual mind map, so I can see the title, main headings, and supporting points laid out like I'm prepping a keynote speech. Super helpful. By now, you've probably realized that Poppy isn't just for YouTube videos. You can use this tool to create viral shorts, high-converting ads, posts for X, threads, basically anything across your social media platforms. I've even seen people in the Poppy AI community use it to analyze full MP3 calls and repurpose content into viral videos. That's next level stuff. Just picture this. You've got a full-time job, limited free time, but you still want to build something on the side. Whether it's a weekend content sprint or a brand new side hustle, Poppy AI is the kind of visual drag and drop tool that saves you hours, and in the long run, saves you serious money. Because in this AI era, time really is money. Finally, we've made it to the script writing stage. As you can see, I like to keep things simple. First, I train Poppy with everything it needs. Keywords, storytelling techniques, and the mind map I generated earlier using my video outline. Then comes the final step in the workflow. Give Poppy your title, your hook, your keywords, and your structure, all in a conversational tone, and let the AI script writing magic begin. Now, I know it's a lot of information, which is why I personally prefer working in chunks. I feed Poppy the headings from my outline and have it write one section at a time. That way, if I want to tweak a specific part, I don't have to redo the whole thing. Once the script is done, I gather everything into one Google Doc to give it a final review, and then I move to the next tool. Let me introduce you to InVideo.io. It's incredibly user-friendly and comes with built-in workflows, so all I had to do was select Use My Script, adjust a few settings, and let the platform do the rest. I asked it to pull background music from the YouTube audio library, use stock footage, and narrate the script using a female voice, just as Poppy recommended. In just a few clicks, InVideo analyzed my script and turned it into a fully produced video. Want to see the final result?
Japan just became the number one trending destination globally for 2025. And after visiting 25 of its most breathtaking locations, I finally understand why millions are planning their trips right now. But here's what most travelers are missing. From hidden natural wonders that will leave you speechless to ancient temples that have stood for over 1,000 years, I'm about to take you on a journey through the most beautiful places in Japan that most people never even know exist.
Pretty amazing, huh? Two tools, less than 10 minutes, one engaging piece of content. So, if you're ready to take your weekends and start building a Faceless YouTube channel, here's the play. Use Poppy to write your script, InVideo, create your visuals, and then schedule everything with Metricool in just one sitting across all your social platforms. I've linked everything you need in the description. Want to go even further? Try this setup. Use 11 Labs to generate your voiceover, then head over to Hagen to bring your voice to life with a talking AI avatar. And boom, you've just built your own YouTube automation channel just like this. All right, cool features and all. But is Poppy AI really worth the investment? Give me 1 minute and I'll give you my honest review, the good and the bad. Let's start with the things I don't love. First, I'm not a fan of the credit system. It kind of limits how much content I can create at once. I wish it offered more flexibility, especially for creators who want to test things out without feeling capped. Second, I think a lot of people would appreciate a true monthly plan, something lightweight and affordable just to try the platform. And honestly, it would be great if affiliate commissions were available for monthly plans too, not just the annual ones. And third, the price has gone up. I got in when it was $300 a year. Now, it's $400 annually. So if you're seriously considering it, I'd recommend grabbing it now, because it may only get more expensive from here. Now, let's talk about what I do love about Poppy AI. First, it's a massive time saver. Behind this digital avatar, I'm just a regular person with a busy life. So having a tool that lets me create complete scripts using proven frameworks is game-changing. It's how I built my AI-powered YouTube channel to over 1,000 subscribers and 70,000 views, and it's still growing. Second, I love how visual and easy to use Poppy is. I'm a visual thinker, so having a drag-and-drop interface that lets me paste content, group it, and instantly turn it into a video, that's a win. And because I'm repurposing content, I don't get stuck with writer's block or end up with robotic-sounding scripts. Poppy helps me keep a consistent tone and storytelling style across all my videos. And third, I genuinely appreciate how often the platform gets updated. The team behind Poppy is constantly improving the tool. Since my last Poppy AI tutorial, the dashboard has evolved, and now it's even collaborative, meaning multiple users can work on the same workspace at once. They've even rolled out API integrations, which is a huge plus if you're into AI automation or handling lots of content. Honestly, I'm excited to see what they roll out next. Speaking of AI automation, I've put together a step-by-step tutorial to help you automate your content creation workflow using the best AI tools available, including Poppy. You can watch that video right here on my channel. If Poppy AI sounds like the right fit for you, give it a try using my link in the description. Who knows? You might be the next person offering AI script writing services on Fiverr, turning your weekends into a real income stream. Start earning money with AI content creation today. Poppy makes it easier than ever.